Hello viewers, Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to this session. I am Dr. Farida Yasmin, Associate Professor of Pathology at the Women's Medical College. Today I am going to discuss about a very fundamental and basic topic of pathology, a frequently asked questions of both undergraduate and postgraduate pathology students, that is, how to study pathology. As pathology deals with study of disease, and human body is affected by a lot of diseases, so it's a difficult job to study pathology. But if we follow some steps and read it systematically, then it is not a difficult job. So please don't be panic. Please stay with me. I hope at the end of the session, you will get the answer of the question, that is, how to study pathology. So let's start. Before going to start study of pathology, the first thing we should know, what is pathology? The word pathology is derived from two Greek words, pathos and logos. Pathos means suffering or disease, and logos means study. So pathology means study of suffering or study of disease. We can define pathology as a study of structural, biochemical, and functional alterations of cells, tissues, and organs that underlie disease. When a cells or tissues are exposed to adverse environment, then it show some functional and morphological alteration. And that is the theme of pathology. Pathology describes the functional and morphological alterations of cells due to disease process. When we go for study pathology, already we have much knowledge about anatomy, histology, biochemistry, and physiological aspect of human body. These basic sciences deals with normal structure and functions of human cells and tissues. With this background knowledge, we can study pathology, that is, alteration of human cells and organs easily. And with the knowledge of pathology, we can go for study clinical medicine. So in short, we can say pathology makes a bond or bridge between basic sciences and clinical medicine. Let us salute these noblemen who are the pioneers of various fields of pathology. Their dedication, their discovery is still helping us tremendously to diagnose the disease and to manage patient appropriately. Paul Ehrlich, a great physician who developed techniques of staining cells and bacteria and laid the foundations of hematology and clinical pathology. And for his tremendous work, he is considered as father of clinical pathology. George N. Papanikolaou, an American pathologist, he developed Pap test for diagnosis of cancer of uterine cervix. And this test is utilized in whole world still today for screening cervical cancer. Giovanni B. Morgagni, who developed methodology in the study of disease by correlation of clinical findings with findings at post-mortem examination. John Hunter, who is the father of museum in pathology, established the pathological museum first. There are some branches and subdivisions of pathology. The two main branches of pathology are general pathology and systemic pathology. General pathology deals with the basic reactions of cells and tissues to abnormal stimuli that underlie disease. That is, general pathology explains the basic mechanism of all disease process. Systemic pathology examines the specific responses of specialized organs and tissues to more or less well-defined stimuli. As for example, when coronary arterial blood flow is reduced due to atherosclerotic narrowing, then few myocardial cells undergo necrotic death, that is called myocardial infarction. Like this disease, every diseases of every systems has underlying basic mechanism of disease process. Systemic pathology provided us with all the informations about mechanism of disease process of all systems. Now, I will explain the basic steps of studying pathology. First, we have to answer few questions. That is, why is the disease? Or what is the cause of the disease? That is called etiology of the disease. Then, what are the types of the disease? Or we can classify the disease such as, is the disease inflammatory or neoplastic or genetic or else? How the disease occur? That is the pathogenesis of disease. And where the changes occur? That is in tissue level or organ or cellular level. And then what happens that is the clinical manifestation of disease. So please follow this pattern and you will never forget pathology. The step ladder pattern of studying disease process, that is EPMC, etiology, pathogenesis, molecular and morphologic changes, and then clinical manifestations. I will explain the steps one by one. The first step we should follow during study of disease, that is etiology or cause of the disease. Let us give an example. Here, a patient is suffering from fatty liver. After investigation, we found that the patient is a chronic alcoholic. So, here the etiology of his disease is chronic alcoholism. When the cause of the disease is known to us, then we may call it primary etiology. And when the cause of the disease is unknown, then it is known as idiopathic disease. Pathology provided us the list of all the etiological factors of almost all diseases of our body. Etiology factors may be classified in another way. They are genetic factors and acquired factors such as infections, nutritional status, chemical agent, physical agents, etc. Now, what about pathogenesis of the disease? It means mechanism of disease process by etiological factor. Let us give the same example. Already we know that chronic alcoholism is the cause of fatty liver. Now the second question is, how this alcohol causes fatty liver? Already we know the normal anatomy and histology of liver cells, that is hepatocytes. One of its important function is to metabolize body fat. But alcohol causes liver cell injury, then it cannot metabolize fat, rather the fat accumulated within it, and that is the cause of fatty liver. The third step of studying pathology is to study of morphological pattern of the disease. And there are two types of morphological pattern: gross morphological pattern and histomorphological pattern. Gross morphology means visible change of diseased organ or tissue, and histomorphological pattern means the changes of organs or tissues which we can see under microscope. Here you can see in the left side picture the normal structure of liver, that is it is normal weight, normal size and tan color. But in case of fatty liver, the liver enlarged in size, enlarged in weight, and color is changed from tan to yellow color. Now the histomorphological pattern of fatty liver. In the left side figure, you can see the normal hepatic globule including hepatocytes. There is no fatty accumulation and no other abnormal morphology of hepatocytes. But in the right side figure, you can see clearly the fat accumulation within almost every hepatocytes. And this fat accumulation within hepatocyte causes enlargement of the organ and color change of the organ from tan to yellow. Now the final step of studying pathology, that is clinical manifestation. Clinical manifestation are caused by underlying pathogenesis of the disease. Here you can see a patient with ascites or abdominal distension. Probably this guy is chronic alcoholic for a long time. And for this alcoholism, he developed fatty liver, and after a long period, he developed cirrhosis, and ascites is caused by liver cirrhosis. So for better management of patient, we should know about pathogenesis and morphological pattern of the disease clearly. In summary, I can say the steps of studying pathology: etiology, pathogenesis, morphological changes and clinical features. We can remember the mnemonic EPMC. There are some divisions of pathology also, such as clinical pathology, molecular pathology, hematopathology, histopathology, cytopathology and blood banking. Viewers, in my next class, I will explain the objectives and activities of these subdivisions of pathology. So please welcome once again to the world of pathology. When a patient comes to a doctor, then the doctor finds the answer of various questions like why the disease, how the disease and where the disease. If the doctor finds the answer of all the questions, then he will get the diagnosis. I think that's enough for today. Thanks for watching.